Praise ye the Lord. Praise, O ye saints of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord from this time forth and even forevermore. From the rising of the sun until the going down of the same, the Lord's name is to be praised. Are you ready to praise the Lord? Father God, we come before you this evening with humbled hearts. We first recognize that you are God, our creator, our redeemer, our provider. You are everything that we are. We lift you up this evening. We magnify you. And this evening, we have come to praise your name. We pray, dear Lord God, that you remember every family that is represented here this evening, the Straford family, the extended SDF family, or invited guests, members from the community. Remember each one of us this evening, dear Lord God. We pray, oh Lord God, that when this evening shall come to an end, we pray that we leave not the way we came, but just a little bit closer, just a little bit more ready to meet you when you should come. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Praise the Lord, saints.
Hallelujah.
When men come together to worship. As I was looking at some of the roster, and I told Sister Green, I ain't got no business being up here. I'm not a singer like some of these gentlemen that are on the program. But I love my Father. I love my Father. And I think I'm at a church now where a lot of times we do a lot of the contemporary praise team songs, but sometimes we forget songs like Father, I stretch my head to tonight, can we tell the Father how much we love him? There's a song I'm reminded of. I love you forever with all my heart. I love you forever, forever, you're my King. Now this is praise and worship. This is for us all to welcome in the name. I love you. May we all stand across the church forever. With all my heart, with all my heart, I love you forever, forever, you're my King. We're going to say my shelter, my shelter,
my shelter,
forever, in time of storm, in time of storm,
time of storm,
my shelter, forever. Forever, you're my King. We're going to say, your mercy, your mercy,
your mercy,
forever,
forever,
shall follow me, shall follow me.
Your mercy
forever, forever, you're my King.
One more.
Can we say all the glory, all the glory,
all
and the
belongs to you, belongs to you. Oh, all the glory and the honor, oh, forever you're my king. Oh, forever you're my king. Can we just say that? Forever you're my king. Forever you're my king. To the only true God. Oh, forever. Hallelujah.
To be in the house of the Lord one more time. Amen. The word of God says, let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. We're in the house of the Lord on this evening to worship and praise our Lord and our Savior. These young men have gathered on this evening, young men, to worship and praise our God on this evening. On this evening, our master of ceremony for this occasion will be a fellow elder, a brother, and a friend, a man that loves the Lord, the man that prays. We pray together. My friend and my brother, Elder Juan Orozco, come forward at this time.
Good afternoon, church family. I just want to thank God for this opportunity. I've never done anything like this before. Well, may the Lord help me. When men praise, when praises go up, blessings must come down. Psalms 1 and 2 says, oh, clap your hands, all ye people. Shout to God with the voice of triumph, for the Lord Most High is awesome. He is a great king over all the earth. Psalm 48:1 says, great is the Lord and greatly to be praised in the city of our God. Psalms 148:1-13 says, let them praise the name of the Lord, for his name alone is exalted. Psalms 49:1 says, praise the Lord, sing to the Lord a new song, and his praise in the assembly of the saints. Psalms 150 reminds us, praise the Lord, praise God in the sanctuary, praise him in the mighty firmaments, praise him for his mighty acts, praise him according to his excellent greatness, praise him with the sound of the trumpet, praise him with the psaltery and harp. Praise him with timbaland and dance. Praise him with string instrument and flutes. Praise him with loud cymbals, with clashing cymbals. Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. Psalms 133:1 says, behold, how good and how pleasant it is for the brethren to dwell together in unity. When we are created to worship and praise God in spirit and in truth. Them that worship must worship him in spirit and in truth. May the men that have been gathered here together to praise and worship God, may their praise be unto God. May it come from the heart, and may it be a blessing to each and every one of us gathered here today. And without no further ado, we have this young man. He's very young, but he's a scholar, even at his age. We have a soloist, Avery Smith, that will come and share what the Lord has blessed his heart to be a blessing to us this afternoon. Avery.
Songs we sing, yeah, much more than an emblem on a chain, but it means I'm free, yes, from the chains of slavery, and the blood is shed won't let my sins remain. Oh my, upon the cross my Savior died, the Lamb was crucified, showed us love that this world had never known. Oh, what love divine, so divine, truer love you'll never find. So that we might live, love came and died alone. Hallelujah. Well, the cross will always represent the love.
Oh, just for me. I'm encouraged by that young man to press on. When men praise, music is universal. It goes beyond every denomination. It goes and it touches to the very heart of all of us. I just want to thank God for the efforts of that young man. When men praise, at this time we'll have Brother Leon Thompson come forth. Brother Leon Thompson, say amen as he comes.
Thank you. This song has quite a history, but time doesn't permit to tell it, but it tells its own story. I wrote it in 64 when I thought I would have died. I want to be ready.
Singing, praising his name when he comes. I want to be living, yes, living, watching and waiting. Yes, that's when my Jesus comes. See the thrill of glory, how to tell the story of my Jesus when he comes. See the thrill of glory, my Jesus when he comes. Ready, ready, ready when he comes. Ready, ready, ready when he comes. Ready, ready, ready when he comes. Ready, ready when he comes. Ready when he comes. I want with that 144,000 when he comes. Here to be with him in that new Jerusalem. Yes, that's where my Jesus comes. See then the train of glory, how to tell the story of my Jesus when he comes. See then the train of glory, how to tell the story of my Jesus when he comes. Ready when he comes. Ready when he comes. Are you going to be ready when he comes? Will you be ready when he comes? Please be ready when he comes. He'll be waiting, watching, and praying. Yes, I want to be ready when he comes.
Watching, waiting, praying when he comes. Brother Leon Thompson, he's from Suriname. At this time, we'll have our very own Brother Ahmed Gadding. Brother Ahmed, would you kindly come and bless the Lord?
Good evening, saints. I bring you blessings from Faith United Methodist Church, and I'm going to ask for some assistance in a song that some might be shocked with by Marvin Gaye.
Brother we have coming to the stage is David Graham. Brother David Graham, is he in the house? We'll come back to David at a later. Next we will have Brother Bill Nance. Brother Bill.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. I want to give honor to God, of course, but also to Anita and to the committee that that afforded me another opportunity to participate in one of God's programs. I'm going to go old school on you. You know, Ann always told me B flat. So, always singing that key if you didn't know any better. I don't know about tomorrow. I just live from day to day. I don't borrow from its sunshine, for its skies may turn to gray. I don't worry over the future, for I know what Jesus said, and today he walks beside me, for he knows what lies ahead. I don't know about tomorrow. It may bring me poverty, but the one who feeds the little sparrow is the one who stands by me. And the path that is my portion may be through the flame or flood, but his presence goes before me, and I'm covered with his blood. Oh, many things about tomorrow I don't seem to understand, but I know who holds my tomorrow, and I know who holds my hand. Oh, many, 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 many things about tomorrow I don't sing. No, I don't understand. But I know who holds my tomorrow. And I know who holds my hand.
Thank you, Jesus. As Brother Evan says, and I know who holds my hands. We have a little change of pace now. We're going to have a spoken word from Brother Aaron Evans. Brother Evans.
Good evening. My name is Aaron M. Evans. I'm a public speaker, entrepreneur, and currently a film student at DePaul University. I want to first and foremost give all thanks to God for bringing us here and allowing us to come here and fellowship this evening. Thanks also to Pastor Reed and Straford for having me. And this piece that I want to do for you all is entitled Angels. And it directs itself at just the chaos and the turmoil that we see in our world around us. And if you haven't seen, if you haven't caught on the news, it's just institutions are fighting against one another. And it seems like the foundation is beginning to break. And that might cause some people to feel like they're trapped, like they're stuck, like there is no moving, there is no progress being made. But all I see is a God that's saying, no man is in control. I alone reign. There's so many angels on the south side, so many young people anxious praying on the south side, but wait. Half of them really are angels' bodies laying on the south side because clowns want to run around spraying up the south side. And based on what? Foolish pride? I mean, don't we get it enough from their side? Why do we choose to become part of our own genocide? The problem's in our minds, where demons got us dizzy trying to cover all the road signs, knowing that if we merge, the masses will turn into a landmine and detonate. Can anything set us straight? I guess that's unlikely in a world where Juneteenth passes with the expectation of a birthday cake without the realization that we haven't seen freedom since the day they were forced to emancipate. I mean, just 50 years ago, they'd kill a man who chose to demonstrate just to stop anybody else from building the courage to step up and orchestrate. These are the thoughts that run through my mind when it's late and I'm dreaming of running on clouds to bang on heaven's gates begging. Lord, please, please, please save and feed us. And if it's not too much to ask, can you bring forth some legitimate leaders? Because anybody can stand up and be a preacher, but you got to sit and learn to be a teacher. But don't worry. I was a college dropout, so you don't ever got to call me professor. And see, I'm a product of my generation where we understand how they oppressed us and chose to neglect us in order to misrepresent us, leaving us chained up like Rosa when she got dragged off that bus. Oh, shucks, y'all probably looking at me like I'm up here tripping off some angel dust. But what if I'm not? Then I guess it really doesn't matter whether my IQ is down or up, because if I really do find the tree of life, they'll make sure I get my melon bus, but trust, it still won't be enough. And oh, you ask how come? Because as chosen people, we not focused on the evils. We too busy talking to the higher ups who are convincing us that there's nothing that can stop us from being able to do it. So I pray that all of you finds your passion and allows your drive to allow you to pursue it, push through it, and conclude it. Because when you rise from the ashes, outsiders look foolish. This is your time, this is your season. Through traitors, treason, you made it this far because of the king that you believe in. And know that thing that you've been sitting there and you've been struggling and you've been seeking, just know that it's standing there right in front of you if you just trust yourself enough to reach out and receive it. Thank you.
Young black man, speaking of the struggle that black folk has had over the years and continue to have as the generations have changed over the years, but the struggle is still real. Coming to the stage now is our very own brother Joe Milton. Say amen as he comes to share his selection.
Before I attempt this song, I sat across the desk from my surgeon. I had already been to my ENT, ear, nose, and throat. Most of us have a thyroid. Thyroid's about the size of a walnut. It's about like that. He said mine was the size of a grapefruit. He started asking me crazy questions like, do you have trouble breathing? Do you have trouble sleeping? Do you have trouble eating? Okay, look at me. I ain't missed too many meals. I couldn't understand why he was asking me all this. He said, the size, they call it a goiter after it grows. The goiter was holding my neck up. So he did the surgery. Well, They always tell you the worst things that can come out of a surgery. They don't tell you the good news. They have to tell you the worst thing. The worst thing he said was, we may have to take your voice box. You know, when people do like this to talk. My voice box. My wife told me, it's okay. We'll get through it. That's that faith.
Questioned, even failed to believe, he was faithful. Even though I have questioned, even failed to believe, he was faithful. Even failed to believe. He was faithful. The Lord, He is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. Yea, He restoreth my soul. To me,
amen. Even in sickness, God is yet faithful. When I think about the goodness of Jesus and what He performed on that old rugged cross. That cross symbolizes death, burial, and resurrection that gives us life. He was willing to die that you and I may have an opportunity to the tree of life. Now more than ever, now is the acceptable time to praise the Lord for His goodness and His mercy endureth forever. God has been faithful to us. He was willing to leave His heavenly throne and to come down to earth, become poor, that through Him we might become rich. We might not have the fancy homes. We might not have the fancy cars. Give me Jesus. I'd rather have Jesus than silver and gold. Next coming to the stage, we have the Right Reverend Dr. Tony Fisher. My brother, it's all yours.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I thank God for the opportunity to come and to share, giving honor to God, who is the head of my life, to Pastor Reed, God bless you, certainly to Dr. Nita Green for giving the opportunity, and to all of Straford family and my brothers in the Lord. And I don't want to go and, you know, give my testimony, because it'll be about next year when the men come back. But I'll just say this, that God is just so awesome. He's a wonder. And so I thank God that I'm just honored to serve Him. But I will say this, that when you're going through something, it's basically because there is a wonderful expected end. And so what you do is you bear that in mind and you go through. It's better than being stuck. Amen? Amen. So you go through. Sometimes it may not necessarily be for you. It'll be for somebody else. But going through is an honor, because it lets us know what God is able to do. I'm just going to sing for you a little song from Richard Smallwood, entitled Holy. God is holy, isn't He? But now before I sing, I need to ask you a favor. Now if I start praising the Lord, don't let me praise Him by myself. Huh? And so therefore, can we do that? If folks are praising the Lord, don't let them praise Him by Himself. You know, praise Him with me. David said, oh, magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt His name together. I found that when the praises go up, amen. I might need for you to hold this for me on this side. Wonderful sound system. Just an incredible feedback. Holy, holy. Lord God, if you know it, sing with me. Almighty, holy, holy, Lord God, Almighty, heaven and earth are glory, oh heaven and earth are full of thy glory, Lord, holy and righteous is your name, omnipotent, glorious, holy is your name. For me one more time, holy, 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 Lord God, Almighty, holy, holy.
Like Brother Al Morrison, share a selection with us. Yeah. Say amen, he's Straford zone.
I'm attempting to sing, you know,
had a song in mind, and I thought about Brother Joel. It was good to see him again, and the various ones. But I got a testimony too. Yeah. You ain't seen me in a while. And I went from the bed. I was sick. I caught a parasite. And I'm on dialysis 3 times a week. And I was at a place in my life that I was standing up against the wall. And I said, well, what you gonna do, Morrison? Now you got this sickness. Mama ain't here. Grandmama gone. Daddy gone. All your folks gone. You're the only one here in the city. I said, I'm going to trust the Almighty. That's right. Amen. I ain't going to have no pity party. I've had pity parties before. I done had some. The church folks have pity parties. They don't want to tell you they have them, but they do. Amen. But every once in a while, you know, you got to say, well, you know, I'm not going to have a pity party. I'm not going to get mad at the Almighty. Because that's what we do. We get mad at him. You know, and so I said, I'm going to believe the Almighty. Now, I'm going to tell you something. You know, doctors are scientists. You got them. There's nothing wrong with them. We got to have them. We got to have our nurses. We're going to have our CNAs. We're going to have to have all those people. They're very necessary. But you got to be a believer. Yes. When the doctor say you got cancer, okay, that's your diagnosis. That's your prognosis, whatever that is. You know? And they're going to do whatever they can do for you. Right? Well, you got to be a believer. See, that's what I was. I didn't realize I was that good a believer. I didn't put a whole lot of stake in it. But, you know, I had to believe. When your back is against the wall, you got to believe. Either you're going to believe or you're going to go away from here because they said so. See, what do you believe? I believe what the scripture says. These signs shall follow them that believe. They shall lay hands on the sick and they shall what? They shall what? They shall recover. You got to believe that. That's what I believe. So what happened? My oncologist, I hadn't seen him in a while. When he saw my feet swelled up, I'm wearing 13. My feet swelled up to a 16. I caught a parasite from India. I ain't never been to India. I can't tell you how to catch it. So I sat there and I said, wow, what you going to do, Morrison? I said, I'm going to believe the Almighty. That's what I'm going to believe him. I'm going to stand right here and believe him. Went to my oncologist 8 months later. He looked at me. He said, what happened to you supposed to have this? And you supposed to have that. And I said, yeah, I had all that. I said, I had all that, but the Almighty took it. My doctor said, listen, we're trying to find out what's wrong with you so we can help you. He never found out. I told him, I didn't know what I was saying. What if you don't find out? I don't know what I was saying. What if you don't find out? He never found out. And so my oncologist, they called me back to look me over again. And he looked at me. I want to say one more thing. A lady said to me, when I went to my dialysis, I was going to my chair to get my treatment. And the lady said to me, she said, I was walking past, you know, she right here, I'm walking past. She said, I don't like the idea. She's 88, smart as a whip. She said, I don't like the idea that I got to be on this for the rest of my life. I come along around about that time, moving on along, and I said, it depends on what you believe. If you believe what the doctors tell you, if you believe what the technicians say, and that's your world is science, but the mighty one is a greater one. See, the brother said it today. He said, some things you go through is not just, it's for you, but not just for you. There's some people you will never see in this place right here. But when you go to them hospitals and see those folks and they see you, and when the nurse said, listen, what happened to you wasn't the act of the doctor. My nurse said, Toya said to me, said, Mr. Moe, Mr. Albert, they called me. Mr. Albert, what happened to you was an act of God.
She was my nurse. She said it was an act of God because we cannot explain what happened to you.
The lady said, well, do he work for us or what? I'm walking around like there were people who were being wrapped like I was. I was wrapped from my feet to my knees every day. You know, the people that was wrapped at the time I was wrapped, they still being wrapped today. I moved out and got my own place and everything and walking for myself, doing everything for myself. There was a time I couldn't do it, but I thank the Almighty. I didn't get up here to do all that. But then these guys got up here and talk. When you start talking like that, you know, you got to stop. You know, when you start talking like that, I'm going to try to sing this song and get out the way. But that's what I had in my mind. I'm going to sing this song and get out the way. But when I got up here, I couldn't help it. That brother started something. You can see, when you start fire now, it's hard. It's contagious. You know, so I had to say something. I couldn't get by without saying something. Ah, hallelujah. Time to represent. Here's the time to represent. Yeah. So the only savior they're gonna see is the one they see. Some folks, the only savior they're gonna see, they don't go to church. The only savior they're gonna see is the one in Brother Joel, the one in you, the one in you back there. That's the only savior they're gonna see. I'm gonna try to sing this song. I'm trying to wind down. I got a song I was supposed to sing. I told Sister Nita, I'm gonna sing this song. But there's a song that keeps reverberating in my heart. And I don't know the song that well. That's it. You had a song. My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you. That's all I could get out of my mouth. My hallelujah belongs to you. You deserve it. You deserve it. You deserve it. Yeah, yeah. You deserve it. My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you. Oh, my hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you. You deserve it. Thank you, my brother. You deserve it. You deserve it. You deserve it. I'ma close. My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you.
My hallelujah belongs to you. deserve it. Help me, brothers, help me.
My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you. You deserve it. You deserve it.
Amen, amen, amen. Whose report do you believe today? Whose report do you believe? There are those that are sick and can't get well. Some battling cancer, some diabetes, some battling depression, some battling the enemy, just bombarding their minds, trying to bring them down to a state of depression. But God is able. God is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we should ask or even imagine. God is all that we will ever need. Praise the Lord. At this time, we have another brother come to the stage. Brother Andre Owens. Brother Owens.
Let's not stop the worship. Let's stay right there for a little while. Lord, you're worthy. You are great, oh God. There's no one like you. There's no one before you. You are greater than we could ever be to ourselves, oh God. We love you back on tonight, oh God. Thank you for being everything that you are to us, oh God. Thank you for always being there when we couldn't be there for ourselves. Thank you, oh God, for being there when our mothers and our fathers couldn't even be there. Thank you, oh God, for bringing us out, oh God, into messes that we got ourselves in. Thank you, oh God, for being such an understanding God. Thank you, oh God, for being such a merciful God. Thank you for being such a faithful God. Thank you for being such a gracious God. Lord, we thank you, God, for everything that you've done for us, oh God. Oh, hallelujah. 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 Oh, my God, y'all done messed me up. And I just got off work. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. I told them I wish I hadn't got off work so I could look just as wonderful as everybody else do right now. But, you know, we thank God for opportunity, and we thank God for his presence. Thank you, Lord, that he don't judge us about what we wear and what we do and what we say. He uses us anyway. Anyway. No matter how big of a dummy you might think you are, there's somebody always worse, and there's somebody that God is always trying to use just because he made you. Who are we? Oh, I'm supposed to sing this song, Jesus, the blood of Jesus. So, giving honor to God and the pastor of this house and to this house, which is in this beautiful edifice. I've rode past this 100 times, never been inside. It's beautiful. Sister Anita gave me the challenge to sing tonight. And I said, me? You're funny. And because I'm a young man, I just turned 30. And you know how before you turn 30, though, you think you know everything, and then 30 hits, and you go, ooh, Jesus. Lord, I was stupid. Thank you, Lord, for blessing me and my stupidity. Thank you, Jesus. And you know, we laugh about that, but everybody knows it's kind of true. So some of us went back to our mamas and daddies and go, could you raise us again? So, but God's blessed me so much. You know, God blessed me with a job. I work at Starbucks at O'Hare. And you know, when I was coming back, this is my second year, I just went on tour with Dexter Walker and Zion Movement to Italy and Hungary. And that was a beautiful experience and something I know I did not deserve. So I give God all the glory. Came back to Starbucks and I was like, Lord, what do you want me to do? Because I don't want to look at this as just a job. I don't want to look at it as an assignment. And then, you know, the Lord in his great way sometimes doesn't always speak back to you. He just leads you into his answer. And I go, Lord, okay, I'm here. Use me. And then I start getting into singing. Lord was like, just sing. I was like, what? Starbucks, really? It's coffee. It's
said just sing. And the opportunities that has happened and the spirit changes that has happened and the atmosphere changes that God has used is amazing. So when I thought of that and I thought about the stuff that was going on and how God has been so gracious and so faithful, it led me to this song. Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not, thy compassions they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever wilt be. Summer and winter, in my life there's springtime and harvest. The sun, moon, and stars in their courses above join with all nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy, and love. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Pardon for sin and a peace that endureth. Thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide. He gives me strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings all mine with 10,000 beside. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see, and all I have needed. Stay there, because we think about too much of what we need and what we want. And then we forget who he is. So all I have needed. Got a testimony too. God bought 4 people food with $1 a day for a week in my house. All I have needed. I went to a school I couldn't afford. Couldn't even afford to get there. And God made a way. All I have needed.
What I didn't tell you, though, is God afforded a little black boy from the gardens, though, a way to get to Europe 4 times. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Oh, great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Thank God it doesn't belong to me, but it belongs to you. Great is thy faithfulness. Even when I'm lost and I don't know how to get back, you are. Great is thy faithfulness. When I'm weak and you are made strong, great is thy faithfulness, Lord, 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 unto me. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Song said, great is thy faithfulness. Have you been blessed by the men who have gathered together to praise and worship God in spirit and in truth? At this time, we want to direct your attention. It's offering time at this time. But I have been given instructions that after this praise and worship session is over, there will be a fundraiser downstairs in the basement. Your kind patronage is greatly appreciated. Please feel free to stop by and have something down there to your liking. At this time, say a quick prayer as we receive an offering. Dear Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you, Lord. Thank you for a high Sabbath day, Lord God. Thank you for the men who have been gathered together to worship and praise you in spirit and in truth. Father, kindly bless the givers, bless the offering, may it be used for your work. In Jesus' name, amen. I'd just like to remind all of us that the fundraisers for the Pathfinders and the work that they do here at the church as well as in the community, this Adventist, the proceeds is going to be dedicated to the children of this church. Thank you.
thank you, those who have given. At this time, we're going to be having a selection, an instrumental selection from Brother Jay Harrison. Amen. Brother Jay Harrison.
Thought that would be the end of all of my yeses, but I realized that if you're truly going to serve the Lord, you're going to have to every day say yes to Him. And I want to say to you, I want to be honest to you today, that's probably one of the hardest parts of the Christian journey, because sometimes the way that he wants to lead me, I don't want to go that way. But I know that his way is the best way. Amen. And so today I just want you to join me in a song that simply says, my soul says, yes, this is my prayer to God. This is my heart's desire. And I know this is all of our heart's desire as well. Amen. My soul says yes, says yes, says yes, yes. My soul says yes to your will. Where you lead me, I will follow. When you call me, I will answer. Oh Lord, please teach me how to know your ways. Where you lead me, I will follow. When you call me, I will answer. Oh Lord, please teach me how to know your ways. Whatever it takes, whenever you want, what moment you choose, whatever your plan, oh Lord, let your will be done in me. So be my guide, be my light, be my way, be my will. Let your will be done in me. My soul says yes, says yes. Oh, my soul says yes to your will. Searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody greater, nobody greater, nobody greater than you. My soul says yes, says yes. My soul says yes to your will.
Want to sing that with me?
My soul says yes. Says yes, says yes. My soul says yes, says yes to your will.
One more time, why don't you sing it to him today? My soul,
my soul says yes, says yes, says yes. Says yes to your will.
Amen.
Amen, amen. Do your soul say yes to God's will today? not only to his will, but his way, for his way is perfect. Our will is permissive. At this time, we have our own brother, Willie Jones. Brother Jones.
Hallelujah. Ever since Anita told me that she wanted me to do this, it seemed like I've been plagued. Everything been happening. Then I get here, everybody can sing. The doorknob singing, and the cat meow, and the dogs are barking, and everybody just singing. And then mess around and put this singing pastor right before me. My God. And I said, they got all these wonderful testimonies. I ain't really got a great testimony like that. It's just like God just shook me and said, what you talking about? I thought about the time I was at one of the schools where I teach music, and I had to go from class to class, and my legs went out on me. And I was thinking about this brother, and he really testified. He said some stuff. And I had to crawl to the office, basically. And I said, y'all give me something. Just give me something, because I got to get up. Because I don't want to fall on these little kids, because I'll mash them like mashed potatoes. Give me something. But I went to the doctor, they took the x-rays, and it was like I could barely move. Seemed like I was almost crawling to the doctor. I was in the store, they took the x-rays. I was in the grocery store in Jewel's trying to get some healthy stuff. Maybe let me get some healthy stuff. Tony had given me a list of things that his grandmama had given me. Anita gave me a list of stuff. And I'm like, Lord. The doctor that took the x-rays was a lady doctor. She said, Mr. Jones? I said, yes. She said, well, I want to tell you what's going on. I said, what's going on? She said, you got severe arthritis in your knee, severe arthritis. I said, well, what do you think we can do? She said, well, it's just going to get worse. I said, okay, you know, letting her talk. Like you say, let her talk, because she know the signs were right. But I kept seeing those scriptures that God had been dealing with me about when he said, by his stripes, we were healed. It's not like you going to be healed. You already healed, because he paid for it already. And then I began to think about one of my favorite scriptures says, my God can do exceeding and abundantly above all that we can ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. He's well able, y'all. And one thing I know, that everything is working out for my good, because I am the called according to his purpose. So now, knee, if you're going to hurt, you're going to praise God. And I would go to church and just drag on. They say anything wrong? I say, oh, nothing. And people would just be dancing and praising God. I'd just say, one foot do this till I can, you know. But one Sunday I walked up in there and I said, I need y'all to help me do something. And we just danced a while, thinking about the goodness of Jesus. I think everybody sung every song that I need to say, what you going to sing? And then when I thought I had it together, everybody sang every one of them. This boy testified, the Holy Ghost came up in here for real, and then did my song. Listen, my song. I didn't write it, didn't record it, but it's my song. But one thing I do know, Jesus, I'll never forget what you done for me. Jesus, I'll never forget how you set me free.
Jesus, I'll never forget how you brought me out. Jesus, I'll never forget. Oh, can you search? Oh, Lord, how you set me free. Hey, Lord, Jesus, I'll never forget. Oh, Jesus. Well, how can I forget what you've done for me? How can I forget how you set me free? How can I forget, Lord, how you brought me? Thought about it. I said, never, never forget. Can you say it, y'all? Never, 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 never. Say it again, y'all. Say it just a little louder. Jesus, never, never. And it says, Jesus, I'll never forget what you've done for me. Jesus, I'll never forget how you set me free. Jesus, I'll never forget.
In the need of prayer. It's not that I was so good. I know some of y'all been saved all your life and did everything right. But I needed to come to the Lord. I come to thee. I dare you to put your hands together and praise the Lord. And I dare you to open your mouth and magnify him. I dare you to lift your voice. and worship our King. How dare you to praise Him? How dare you to praise Him on purpose? Come on, think about the goodness of Jesus and all that is done for you. Cry out hallelujah. Cry out hallelujah. Hey, yeah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Whew. Glory to God. I didn't know what I was going to do when I get here, but I came here to praise the Lord. I didn't care what I looked like at this point. I came to praise the Lord. I couldn't find nothing I wanted to wear. I said, but I'm going on anyway. Got sick trying to get here during the day. But I'm coming anyway to give God praise. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What key we in? I don't even know where I'm at. We in D flat. Oh, God. I'm going to be real short. I'm already over my time, I know. But that brother testified for 15 minutes and then he sung. I try to stay spiritual. I try. But I find something in everything. Give me an F sharp, a favorite key, I hope. You've been looking for a blessing, and you think it just won't come. Go to four. Life is a block. Go to one. Doors are shut. Go to two, and it seems you can't make it. Go to five, through. See, the devil, four, is a liar and a deceiver, too. I want you to know this. God, one. He ain't through blessing you. God is not through blessing you. God is not through blessing you. See, whatever God has promised, He's able, He's able, He's able to do. Hey, God, He ain't through. Is not through blessing you. God is not through blessing you. See, whatever He has promised. One thing I learned about God, He's not a man that He would lie. Matter of fact, He can't lie. If He said it, it shall be done. And He's able to do. God, He ain't through. God, He ain't through. God, He ain't through yet. put your hands together, thank you.
At this time, we'll have our very own Brother Daryl Gadding. Please say amen as he comes.
Happy Sabbath. I just praise God for being here today. Thank you, Pastor Reef, for opening up the church for us all to praise God together. Thank you also to Nene for considering me for the program tonight. We'll do a medley. Can't say it's going to be short. It's not going to be long, though. For this morning's rising,
yeah.
New mercies given, I thank you. For every miracle manifested, great or small, I praise you. Yet there is one thing my heart desires, is to worship you each day without fail. This is my earnest prayer. This is my earnest plea. Bid me come ye beyond the veil.
Next song.
Tell me, what do you do when you've done all you can? It seems like it's never enough. Tell me, what do you say when friends turn away, you're all alone? Tell me, what do you give when you've given your all and seems like you can't make it through? Well, you just stand, you stand, you stand. Don't you dare give up after you've done all you can. After you've done all you can. After you've done all you can, you say, Jesus, you are, I know y'all know this, the center of my joy. Jesus, you are the center of my joy. Jesus, you are the center of my joy. You are everything, 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 everything. You're my joy. Sorrow, you're my
Amen. Last but not least, Brother Maurice Hyde. Say amen as he ministers to us.
Now, you know, if y'all tired, y'all go home. I don't have to do this. But it's a blessing to be in the house of the Lord. I'm just glad to be here. And I'm glad somebody wants to be in the house of the Lord, because it seems like everybody else wants to do everything else. But I'm glad to say I'm still here. Mama gone, daddy gone. Stepmama gone, stepdaddy gone. Grandmama, grandmama, granddaddy, granddaddy. But I'm still here. Getting Social Security, I'm still here. Gonna get Medicare soon, I'm still here. And I'm glad. Though the storm keeps on raging in my life, and it's hard to tell the night from day, still that hope that lies within is reassured as I keep my eye upon the distant shore. I know He'll lead me safe to that blessed place He has prepared. But if the storm don't cease, and if the wind keep on blowing, my soul has been anchored in the Lord, the Lord. I realize in this life we're gonna be tossed by the way that seems so fierce. Oh yes, they will. But in the Word of God, I've got an anchor that's gonna keep me steadfast, unmovable, despite the time. If the storm, if the storm, if the storms don't cease, and just in case the wind keep on blowing, blowing in my life, my soul has been anchored in the Lord, 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 in the Lord. You know the billows may roll, breakers may dash, I won't sway because He holds me back. Oh, darker day, clouds in the sky, I know it's all right, cause Jesus is right. You know, when in the valley, didn't go to stay, no, got happy and I stayed all day. Jordan's river, chilly and wide, I
Amen.